I spoke, I made it for 2 to 5 minutes, and I finally was totally incoherent because it was fun. And the two things were this part, it's Parsha, and from Sukkos. Parsha's Noach, my grandfather said I had an aura. Why the rainbow is the simon of a Kushbok's blasphemy. That is because it's the chesed which comes through the clouds which represent din. So therefore, the time, even the time of din, there's always chesed which comes through. And that's the place, the memories of my mother. Even this time of din, they have impact upon us. It's a positive influence. And I mentioned that he writes, he has a very long drasha, which I will not repeat in Tzitari, he will repeat there in Tzitari, on Sukkos, where he talks about how the sukkah is from the Russian of socheh, it's the gates. It says, ask you questions, says, why sukkah has runs from the same thing that Pesach would be a much more appropriate time? And they ask, why there's, but Yisra Ach Sameach refers to Simchas Torah, why is that a special time of Simcha? And he says that because sukkah is a lotion of gazing, it means, why are we called Ellis and I'm Sukkos? He says it means to gaze ahead and look, see the ultimate goal and the ultimate perspective on that goal. And that is so the mark on the Shmaso Kiyuelis and Sosa of Shmork is that goal other. And that's what we call Ellis, because whatever happens in this world, the way to get through it is to completely always look at that end point and that purpose. And that culminates obviously in Simchas Torah because of all the Torah itself being the source for all this. And Sukkah, this road, he says, is only a way station along the way to the ultimate goal. But he says, just like the Sukkah is a diras arai, it's a temporary dwelling place, so too this world is a temporary dwelling place. But there's a halacha by sukkah, tasev alomin asui. You have to make your own sukkah. You can't, nobody else can make it. The sukkah has to be made, you can't take a sukkah which is already made. So everybody, even though it's a diras arai, you have to make it and leave your mark in this world, to make an impression in this world. And then it becomes obviously your diras keva after 120. So I said that my mother left her mark on the world, and she made a depression and a roshim of Kiddush Hashem, and we should continue with her footsteps. That's what I tried to say.